Excellencies, distinguished guests, dear friends, it is for me a pleasure to share with you, as we conclude our time together, a brief reflection on the significance of the final conciliar document Nostra Aetate, which in my opinion witnesses to the opening and to use a term dear to Pope Francis, to the mercy with which the Catholic Church has looked and continues to look at life in our world. I thank all of you who are here and who have shared this afternoon moments of reflection that were, I believe, a tangible sign of the willingness of the Catholic Church to dialogue with our brothers and sisters of other religious traditions as advocated by Nostra Aetate. Could I summarize with two words what we have been sharing together in this rich presentation and discussion? Could it be said in this form? What we have proclaimed is just our desire to live in unity and in diversity. It is true that in these 50 years, much has been accomplished, but much still remains to be done. Although many words have been said, there also have been, and there are, too many silences. The path indicated by Nostra Aetate is still today a very demanding one, and as we read in the declaration, we continue to be urged to recognize, preserve and advance all the spiritual, moral, and sociocultural values found in religions. The Pontifical Council for Interreligious Dialogue, of which I am the secretary, is aware of its debt to all those council fathers, to be exact, there were 2,221 fathers, one of them who on the 28th of October, 50 years ago, with great courage and foresight, approved the declaration Nostra Aetate. We are also indebted to all those who in the past 50 years, from whatever religion to which they belonged, have promoted interreligious dialogue. Let me also thank the International Dialogue Center, CAICID, for all the efforts made towards the promotion of interreligious dialogue and for the many different initiatives that support people of different religions to come together in this hub, to get to know each other and to learn to work together for the good of humanity. Nostra Aetate urged that encounters between believers like this one of today have a clear identity and a spirit of respect, esteem, and collaboration. In this regard, I would like to recall here what was said by His Eminence Cardinal Thorin at the inauguration of the International Dialogue Center, CAICID, when he expressed the hope that our initiatives would be conducted with vision, honesty, and credibility. In these times, for many reasons, dark and difficult, I believe that the purpose of interreligious dialogue is to take a common path towards the truth. This journey needs to take into account this aspect, the identity of the person who is dialoguing, that one cannot talk out of ambiguity, that each must pay attention to the other, that those who pray and think differently from me are not an enemy, and that the intentions of each must be sincere. We must undoubtedly strengthen the fruitful cooperation among believers, among us believers of different religions, on issues, as it has been stated, of common interest and need for the good of the human family and of our common home. It is necessary to preserve the universal spirit with which Pope Francis speaks in his encyclical Laudato Si, and I quote, "The majority of people living on our planet profess to be believers. This should spur religions to dialogue among themselves for the sake of protecting nature, defending the poor, and building networks of respect and fraternity." So here, in this number 201, I think we may find a road map to go ahead together. I think I can say that the years ahead will see the Catholic Church even more committed to respond to the great challenge of interreligious dialogue. 50 years of Nostra Aetate has achieved many things, but as I said, there is still a long way to go. And 50 years ago, the declaration opened a door that clearly has not been closed. Indeed, the Council document is still an encouragement for all of us to never close the door or the window, for using the words of Father Newhouse, and because its message is timeless. Let me just recall to you some points. The growing interdependence of peoples, the human search for the meaning of life, suffering, death, the profound human questions which remains valid because of their permanence. We are all human beings. The common origin and the only destiny of humanity. The unicity of the human family. Religions searching for God or the absolute within the various ethnic groups and cultures. These are words of Nostra Aetate, and these are very, very challenging and timeless message we receive from this declaration. We know now more than ever that interreligious dialogue is significant and irreplaceable. It is, among other things, a prerequisite for that peace which is a vital condition for everyone, as well as a longing of every human being, which every religion with its religious and human heritage can greatly help to achieve. Let me conclude with the words that Pope Francis addressed to the participants at the recent General Interreligious Audience in St. Peter's Square last 28th of October, where he recommended to all of us two things. One, prayer. We are facing difficult moments, Pope Francis continually he says that we are living in a world war divided into pieces here and there. We are living in a very dark moment of our history, and that therefore dialogue becomes a must that is to be built through and with prayer, to be done through our respective religious traditions. But as believers, we have also to pray on high to God for solving the problems of humanity. And on the other hand, calling us to do good. Wa'amilu as-salihat. Do good. To everybody. So here we have really a beautiful road map ahead to continue celebrating the message of Nostra Aetate. But let me end with what the Pope, among the rest, told us in St. Peter's Square. We can walk together, and I quote, taking care of one another and of creation. All believers of every religion, together we can praise the Creator for giving us the garden of the world to till and keep as a common good, and we can achieve shared plans to overcome poverty and to ensure to every man and woman the conditions for a dignified life. Thank you very much.